Summer's here, so pools have been figuring out how to reopen safely. So what should you expect?
We're at a reduced capacity. We're at about operating at about 25%, and that's just to ensure that there is physical distancing.
And that physical distancing will be important everywhere, from check-in to the change rooms, the locker rooms, and the pool itself. Now, at public pools, on top of the lifeguard, there may actually be a kind of COVID guard, someone whose sole responsibility is making sure that everyone keeps their distance from each other. But obviously, physical distancing doesn't apply to lifeguards saving lives. So don't worry, if you're in trouble, they'll still come get you. Beyond that, it's really going to depend on where you live and what kind of pool you're going to. High-touch surfaces like slides or diving boards might be off-limits altogether. Shared equipment like pool noodles and flutterboards might be out of service. And you may even have to book your swim time ahead of time, or, as is the case with Toronto public pools.
So, in an effort to accommodate everybody, but also ensure the appropriate cleaning of facilities, we clear pools every 45 minutes, we clean them and turn them over for the next group.
Now, a question that a lot of people will have is, can you get sick from the water itself? Well, according to the US Centers for Disease Control, the answer is probably not. Now, that may be in part because of all of the chlorine in the pool, but also just because of how much water there is. The coronavirus would be so diluted. That being said, while you're having fun, maybe don't spit or blow your nose in the water. You can wear goggles if you like to protect your eyes, but just remember, if you get sick from being in a pool, it will very likely not have been because of the pool itself, but rather because you were too close to other people.